What's up, y'all? We're back with another episode of Bay Area Spots.
This week, we're going to Val's Burgers in Hayward down B Street. And this week, our feature is...
your boy, Sev.
So let's get into it. So we just got back,
and this is what we think about Val's.
So Val's is family owned. It's been in Hayward for quite a bit.
And when you walk in, you definitely like have that classic diner feel, you know?
The service is great. The staff is super friendly.
And personally, like if I would have to pick a place to eat, it'd definitely be Val's.
And who knows, if you're lucky, someone might just pay for a whole meal like they did for us.
Yep. Yeah. I got a baby burger with cheddar cheese, lettuce, and bacon on it. I also added a chocolate banana shake, which Trenton Robbins put me on, and it was so smack. What I personally favored about the milkshake was that they gave me everything in the blender, so it totaled up to like 2.5 glass milkshakes. So overall, my experience at Val's, I definitely give it a 9.5 out of 10.
So I had the baby burger too, with Swiss cheese, lettuce, and tomato. I also had the coffee milkshake, which was pretty good, and overall, the quality of the meal was solid. Personally, I'd give it a 9.234 out of 10.
Since I was in the mood for breakfast, luckily Val's actually serves breakfast all day. So what I got was the number one on the breakfast menu, which came with two slices of French toast, an egg, and two slices of bacon. What I liked about the French toast mainly is that you can tell it was made from scratch because you can definitely taste the egg in it. And I also got the chocolate milkshake, which was also pretty fire. And I'd give my overall experience about an 8.5 out of 10.
All right, so we all really did enjoy our experience at Val's.
The price that we paid for our burgers was definitely worth it. Like, I mean, it was $13 to $15, kind of pricey, but comparing that to like In-N-Out, you definitely wouldn't get the same quality, the same taste, the same feel as you would get at Val's.
Exactly. The only downside to it really is that the place is kind of small and the parking lot could get pretty packed, so you should go at a good time.
So that's all we have for you for today's episode. So we'll see you next time on
Barrier Spots. Walk in, I gotta film, okay?